One, two, three.
Oh man, the water's seeping in.
Oh, I got one, I got one. Holy mackerel, there it is.
There's a famous song that goes, "Country roads take me home to the place I belong, West Virginia." And on this adventure, we will be following an old gravel country road that will hopefully take us to the place that one very rare creature calls home.
This is West Virginia. First time I have ever filmed in this state. Many creatures we can come across. Now it's just a matter of taking this gravel path further into the wilderness, and then we'll break trail into the underbrush and see what we can find. Are you guys ready?
Let's do it.
All right, let's go.
Today we are working alongside field herpetologist Tim Brust, who has spent many summers researching the various creatures that call this wild and wonderful state home. And while he specializes in reptiles and amphibians, today we are after one incredibly elusive crustacean that for now, we will simply call the blue crayfish.
This is cool. We have a little stream system that is moving right through the middle of the forest. This is actually a great place to look for small woodland frogs and salamanders. Look at this.
Most of the time you imagine crayfish living in streams and rivers. However, the species we are searching for today is a variety of burrowing crayfish that lives underground. They can be found in areas known as seeps, which are defined as a wet place where groundwater reaches the Earth's surface from an underground aquifer. Similar to the fully aquatic crayfish species, the burrowing crayfish also hides under rocks. So it was just a matter of flipping the right one.
So Tim, this is what's considered seepage. Here, Mark, take a look at this. See all this water here just in this low spot?
Yeah.
This is actually seeping out from the hillsides, right?
Yep.
So Tim tells me that this rock right here is a great example of something we should flip that may have a crayfish underneath. And I can see this is all real moist right here. You see all this water? It looks like we're just on leaves, but you peel the leaves back and you've got water. So there could actually be a crayfish under this rock. Oh, there's a lot of water there. Guess I just put my hand in there and see if there's anything in it. Oh, there's definitely a burrow right there. But no crayfish. All right, let's keep going.
From rock to rock we searched, gently flipping each one and placing it right back in the exact same spot so that we did not alter the design of the environment.
Oh, jeez.
Whoa, what is that?
That's a huge slimy salamander. Oh, and it is slippery. Oh, come here.
Got it?
I got it, yes. Wow, that is an enormous slimy salamander. That's probably the biggest one I have ever seen. Now they're called slimy salamanders because they excrete a slime from their skin. It's almost like a slug. It is very, very sticky. Let me turn you like this. You gonna sit up on my fingers there? Wow, that is a giant salamander. Much bigger than the salamanders that we catch in Ohio. And look at that cool patterning. Almost looks like the spots of a spotted salamander. Now this is a lungless salamander species. They actually breathe through their skin. So I don't want to handle it for too long. And you can see I'm trying not to actually handle it, like grasp onto it, because I don't want to take moisture from its skin. But just handling it a tiny bit and my fingers are extremely sticky. Now one cool thing about salamanders is that they can actually, well, most varieties can detach their tails. It's called caudal autonomy, the same thing that lizards are capable of doing, and that helps them escape from predators, and then that tail will rejuvenate itself. Well, what a great find. It's not a blue crayfish, but still pretty cool to get this salamander up close for the cameras. All right, I'm gonna dip it in water, place it back under the rock, and we'll keep searching. Sound good?
Great start.
All right, here we go. Yeah, here, come here, check this out. Oh, come on. Oh, I got one.
Dude,
I got one.
Oh.
Yes, but it's not blue. It's a crayfish, but it's not blue.
Yeah, let's go down and take a look.
Oh, he's rearing up with those claws. Look at that. Oh, man, every time. Yeah, he's just holding on with those pinchers. Oh, the next pincher's about to pinch me too. All right, little buddy, I appreciate that. Can you call ahead to some of your cousins who are blue? That's what we're really looking for. I knew I was gonna get pinched. Ah, oh, man, it's one cool little crustacean though. A little fossorial crayfish. All right, back under the rock with this crayfish. We're gonna continue searching.
You can flip rocks for hours and come across nothing. But that's what makes it fun, because there's always going to be another rock. And all it takes is flipping the right rock to uncover a jewel of the wilderness.
I'm telling you guys, you're not gonna believe how blue this little animal is until you actually see it. Actually, this rock right here, before we walk past it, looks perfect. That's a huge rock.
I think you could do it. Muscles, come on.
Oh man, I don't think I can.
You've been hitting the gym.
I don't think I can lift that one.
That's a two-hander.
That's a weird beetle. You need to see it and see if it's possible.
Oh yeah. Oh,
yeah, it's gonna be a whopper.
Let's do it.
That's a big rock right there. All right, here we go. I'm gonna lift it. You ready? One, two, three. Oh, I got one. I got one. Holy mackerel. There it is.
Whoa.
That is a blue crayfish.
I told you. Got that rock.
Heavy rock. And it paid off with a blue crayfish. Look at that thing. Okay, I'm gonna leave this rock position just like this.
Okay, let's come over here.
Let's back up to the trail. Wow.
Yeah, this is good, this is good.
Look at that. Can you believe how blue that crayfish is? Hold on, I'm gonna turn it like this and kind of hold it by its tail. There it is, the sapphire of the West Virginia hillsides. It is so blue, I can't believe it. It is as blue as the sky is. Look at that crustacean.
Wow.
That must be the coolest looking crayfish I have ever seen. Now, this is a species that is subterranean, which means that they have burrows that can go down as deep as 8 feet under the ground, and they will come up into those little pools of water underneath the rocks to search for food. Now, these crayfish do not grow to be very large. This is about average size, and it is a female, and the way that I can tell that is by looking at its underside. It does not have these little kind of grappling legs underneath there, where if it was a male, it would use to grasp onto a female. And I can also tell that this one has a regenerated claw. If you didn't know this, most crustaceans, especially crayfish, are capable of losing claws and then they regenerate them. So this claw right here is a little bit smaller than that claw. So at some point, a predator likely tried to eat it, it dropped its claw, and then it managed to escape. And now that claw is growing back.
So I heard that these crayfish, they can actually drown in water. So if you found one of these, you wouldn't want to release it in the stream.
No, they go in water. Their burrows oftentimes are filled with water, but they have to keep coming to the surface to breathe. Now, they do have gills, just like aquatic crayfish, but those gills allow them to breathe air. So you may be wondering to yourself, Coyote, don't you need to put this thing back into the water? Is it going to suffocate by being out in the open air? No, not at all. This crayfish is breathing right now.
So Coyote, we actually need to get some data while we're out here, correct?
That's right. It is possible that this is a new subspecies of this crayfish. Now, there are two recognized species, and it is possible that this one could be a third. So what we're gonna do is take some really detailed photographs and mark the GPS coordinates, and you never know, this may be a completely newly discovered crayfish. How cool would that be?
That would be awesome. Do you think they'll let us name it?
Maybe, and if we were able to name it, I would call it the sapphire crayfish because in my opinion, this is a lost jewel here in the hillsides of West Virginia. Coyote Pack, what do you guys think? The sapphire crayfish? I like it. Well, I would say it was a pretty epic adventure today. We flipped over many rocks, we found salamanders, we found a brown crayfish, and then of course, the last largest rock revealed to us this little blue beauty. I'm Coyote Peterson. Be brave. Stay wild. We'll see you on the next adventure.
The blue crayfish is one of the most uniquely colored animals we have ever come across. Its elusive nature and subterranean dwelling made it difficult to find, but in the end, the long search was completely worth it. As of the release of this episode, this subspecies of crayfish has officially been classified as a new discovery and is in the process of being described by scientists. And when it comes to the common name officially becoming the sapphire crayfish, well, that's still up for debate, and we are told there is a chance it may actually happen. So I'll continue to keep my fingers crossed. If you thought a brilliant blue crayfish was incredible, make sure to go back and check out another brightly colored creature of the West Virginia mountainsides, the cave salamander. And don't forget, subscribe so you can join me and the crew on this season of Breaking Trail.